Hi, I'm Mark Towers from Waters Corporation, and today I'm going to talk to you about lipid visualization and identification through collision cross-section aided correlation of MALDI imaging and MSMS fragmentation dataset. Mass spectrometry imaging is fast becoming an established technique within lipidomics research. Using MSI, we can visualize a broad range of lipid species. However, subsequent identification can be difficult due to the large number of isobaric or near isobaric species. One thing you can do is you can perform in situ MSMS on the tissue section. This allows you to use the spatial correlation information to ensure that the lipid you're looking at is the correct lipid for your image. However, you're limited in the number of species you can identify through this approach due to the limited surface area of the tissue section. Another way you can do this is to extract the lipids from the same tissue section or a consecutive tissue section. When you do this, however, there's a certain amount of uncertainty because you've extracted the lipids and you've removed them from the tissue section where you've got your imaging data, so you've lost your distribution information. And this means that, as I said, because there are multiple lipids that could have similar or the same mass, you cannot guarantee that the lipid that you identify in your subsequent MSMS is the same as the lipid you have seen within your imaging data set. So here we've been looking at using cross-sectional areas to allow us to better correlate the two data sets. So we've acquired an imaging data set. So this was performed on a rat brain section. We used 9A as a matrix, and this was performed in negative mode. So what we saw was between the range of 400 to 1150 within the lipid range, we were able to identify 7,598 potential ions. However, obviously not all of these are lipids. So what we've done is we've generated a database using information from the lipidmaps.org website. This is a database which contained the fatty acyls, glycerolipids, glycerophospholipids, and sphingolipids. So when we matched this database against our 7,500 peaks, we were able to identify 195 peaks which matched our database plus or minus 3 ppm. When we plot this to show the M over Z and the cross-sectional area, we can see that there is a dominant trend line through the center of our data set. But there's also a number of collisional cross-sectional outliers, majority of which are showing cross-sections much lower than we would expect for a lipid species. So we can use this trend line to filter our data set and remove some of these potential spurious matches. When we do this, this leaves us with 168 potential lipid candidates. So we still don't know that these are definitely lipids. All we have is the accurate mass information that indicates that they probably are lipids. So what we did next was we took a consecutive tissue section and performed some extractions from that. For one tissue section, we used a chloroform-based extraction, which is a more typical lipid extraction liquid. So this was chloroform ethanol 2:1. But we also used a composition that was the same as our matrix composition, just without the matrix. So this was 70% ethanol water. When we've extracted the lipids, we've run them by MSMS, and here we've got the spectra. So at the top, we've got the imaging MS spectrum, and then we've got the extract 1 and the extract 2. We then ran the extracts against the same database and performed the same procedure that we'd used on the imaging data set. So when we did this, in extract 1 we had 72 potential lipids, in extract 2 we had 74 potential lipids. And when we compare these against our data set by looking at the accurate mass, which lipids were identified in both data sets, but then also compare it to the cross-sectional areas of our imaging data set, we ended up with a list of 50 potential matches. From that, we were able to get a list of 38 potential glycerophospholipids, which we have then subsequently identified by MSMS, resulting in a total of 36 lipids being identified. Now, because this is in negative mode, we could only generally rule it down to one of two isoforms, because we can't tell apart the SN1, SN2 order, which is the longer and which is the shorter chains. But once we've done this, we can then go back to our imaging data set and we can pull out the relevant images for MSMS. So now we have a set of images which aren't just images of potential lipid candidates. These are images of things that we are pretty sure are lipids, and we know what those lipids are. So in conclusion, Screening MALDI imaging data sets against the relevant databases allows for significant data complexity reduction. The CCS areas can be used as an additional filter to remove spurious results. CCS areas can be used as an additional filter to remove spurious matches. Lipids can be extracted directly from the tissue sections to allow for the MSMS identifications, and by using the CCS area as an additional qualifying factor when we compare these data sets, it allows for an increase in confidence that the matches we're seeing in our identifications are the same as the peaks we are seeing within our imaging data set. Thank you for your attention.